Well, I'd be much more frightened to be this guy than him. A 12-volt car battery certainly scares me more than a 1.5. This TNT seems like it's going to do a lot more damage in its explosion than this will as it burns. And this is certainly more intimidating than this. Now, it's not always the case that what's more frightening has greater potential energy. But in each of these situations, potential energy could somehow be converted into kinetic energy. If this rock were to fall, it would gain motion, speed, as it fell to the ground. If this dynamite were to explode, the shards would go flying off in all directions. If this bow were released, the arrow would fly through the air at high speed. This one's a little harder to see, but if I were to connect a wire between these two terminals, we'd actually get the motion of what's called electrons through the wire. Likewise here, but more motion here. This idea of energy transforming between potential energy and kinetic energy, and even back again, is one that is fundamental to physics. And I hope that by the end of this unit, you'll be seeing everyday occurrences in terms of their energy transformations. Now, all of these cases exhibited a different type of potential energy. This we would call gravitational potential energy. Burning and combustion and explosion is an example of chemical potential energy, as is a battery. And a bow and arrow is an example of elastic potential energy. In this unit, we're going to focus on making calculations with gravitational potential energy, and in the problems that we'll even talk about elastic. Keep watching to learn how to use this incredible physics tool.